Yeah, we ready.
I do love.
Blessing.
Love your name there, when you tell the world how you come up with a name there.
Yeah.
And why you chose the name.
Well, definitely, world, blessing. Zula, I tell you how I come up with the name and why that name choose. The senior officer, Mr. Morris, a custom officer, him recognized my career, recognized me singing at least. Because at them times I didn't have a career, so he acknowledged me singing. And
a friend of yours?
Yeah, he is a friend of mine. Okay. And he's a producer also.
Okay.
He produced a song with DYC, an album and thing. But he hear me sing and thing and say, the name of your have you, you know, say definitely is a nice name, and you're singing your right name, which is Otis Channa. But you need a name, because to your voice, where you have to take over this reggae world or this world with music. So, him say, I'm going to look up a name for me and think back then. So, then him look up the name and come up with Izula. Me, in a them time, I say Izula. It's so nice and different and everything, so me just love it. So that's the way we come up with the name, world. That is the way I come up with Izula.
So Izula means?
Izula.
Look it up, so what it means?
Yeah, Izula. Him tell me that Izula means a spiritual leader. Izula means a spiritual leader. You can look it up for yourself, because I did it also. So it means a spiritual leader. So me just definitely say, okay, fine. Good. Understand. You know what I mean?
So you come from a musical family or just singing every day and you just realize, alright, or is it that your family has a musical background?
To be honest, no. I ain't got no family in no music background. I don't know if no cousin or no uncle or nobody that sing.
What about mommy and daddy?
No, mommy, we just sing for a little normal song. You know, for them church song, when them sing for a Sunday and the Sabbath, or them middle, and them all have vibe. But no, we never really have nobody to take it serious like that. You know what I mean? Me just like, when I'm at school, I'm a virgin them. Them there, they beat the decks. Me, they kind of have something about me, like, me have to show me I sing first before I sing. So, them man, they always have them things on top of them. So, when them there, me kind of just there and when I'm my time, when I plan my thing, I chip in and they must say, yo, you fear sing, sing. One of them named Gregory Bayless. You fear sing, but I tell Gregory, I can't sing, so can I have to plan my something.
Yeah.
But the next man, them will just sing out them love song and them thing, they always sing the covers them. We did never really know them like that.
Yeah.
But me did always just love them, so. But from school, a friend of mine always have boats me and them thing, with them call, like, encourage them. Mm. Say, yo, you have a nice voice if you sing, but never did have the song.
Well, that brings me to my next question. Because since you say you always have singing, and you know what I mean? Why then did you decide to become a singer?
Well, after I left school, daddy and I met say, yo, what gonna happen now? But which part me live at first within the time? Live with some of my family, you know? Blessing to my family, because they always look out for me. Live with some of my family in the whole in a scheme, you know? In the whole villa, and we meet this Rasta man. He tell them, I'm just 19, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And don't know, you live with your family, man, in them scheme house, nice, pretty house and everything. And link up with the Rasta man, and the Rasta man there, and the vibration, nice, because you don't know. I saw it go when you're a young youth, you want to know, some of you go, you know, because it's a crossroad, me end up as a me there, you know. So I have got no to do you know with them. I go over the side so I see the Rasta and come in with somewhere. Just grab me, name Jawise.
Yeah.
Live in England now still. But grab me and him start hold some vibes and there and I sing. And he must say, you know say you can't sing. So I'd say yeah, and then I hold my vibes and till my 5 minutes start not up. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So fine say, yo, Janu. I forgot to do something. So after my head start not up now, him start write something one day, I go check him and him give me a piece of paper and say, sing this, and I start sing. That song about a girl, me never forget it. Like him would say, you know, you always on my mind. Cause me don't know for some reason, maybe some lady did up on the elder mind state, but when he give me the line, I sing it exactly the same way like how him and I met. And he must say, yo, a coincidence, it's you. You know, so anyway, so I start loving vibes and then I just start dragging a music till I start write my own thing and I start say, Tony, you have to go and them something. But, you know? So then kind of I start get serious.
It was a piece of something that you wrote for the very first time. All right. You start doing.
The first song, right, was a song where I say, Rasta youth no loot, Rasta youth no shoot. Rasta youth in a name brand suit. The girls them say him look cute. Lad, lad, lad. Say, out in a my shoes and my name brand this. I'm gonna go check my girl a name like this. Something like them way there, but they just do something. But that was the punch. That knew it, you know? I mean, I said, Rasta youth no loot, Rasta youth no suit. In a name brand suit, cause as I said, we did kind of then at the scheme. So we did clean. So everybody start next, I wonder how you turn Rasta now. So I just said, Rasta youth no loot, Rasta youth no shoot. Rasta youth in a name brand suit. So that was my first song.
Yeah. How has your musical styling changed since then?
It changed like what would I say, like, you know, when you plant a tree, you're not going to expect say, if you plant a coconut tree, you're going to definitely see the blossom come and you're going to grab the blossom and you're going to just, you have to wait till it fits and everything. So me now, it changed for me because I learned a lot in terms of how to do music properly and what kind of music supposed to be done and how it's supposed to be done. In that time, I never did know nothing. I just sing freelance as a youth with just melodies and just something for just grab people attention.
Who are some of the people you've worked with so far in your career?
In my career, to be honest, you know, this is Mr. Milton Moore, Soundproof Records. He's the first one who recorded me a song, a combination song with me and DYCR. Try with me. Yeah. And other than from that, from Mr. Milton Moore, to be honest, you know, I'm gonna make it look in a pretty, pretty way. I record with most of them. But me, I never them number one. I just apprentice hard. I'm not ready for this. They even tell me say go home and come back. Which we even did too. So I don't need to. Please, let me do that the next time. Tell you about some of them, if them come around now.
You think them turning you away helped you? You know, your skills as an artist?
Them turning me away let me improve, like, yes, a lot. Even more than a lot. It make me, you know what I mean? Make me prove. Improve. Yeah, to be honest. Yeah.
So who are you working with now?
Right now, I'm working with, when I say I'm working with, I'm with my family now. BBG, okay? That's where I'm at. I'm a part of it. Yeah? So Izula have a family now. All the years, no one never did accept me as their family. I give it up for my friend them always. I say, look out, Zula, and this and that, and God is true to them, and you not do no homework, and you not do this and that. Tell you the truth, I write the song them for true, and I sing them for true. But no one never did just take me in as a family. But BBG did. So.
Tell us about the song that you have out now. Is that your first?
No, sorry about that. When we say BBG, I mean Wild Truth. War 21. Yeah? Country McCarthy. Okay? Yes. And respect. What you were saying, Princess, blessed love. Yeah.
Tell us about the song that you have out now. Is it your first official recorded song? What's it called? Tell us about it.
No, it is not my first official recorded song. Because, you know, technology step up, people release them sample, this and that and all kind of songs and release where you don't even know. But it's the first song that is giving Isola a real buzz that I did for Wild Tunes. Yeah, it's called Thunderball. Yeah? Lightning, earthquake, thunderball, shake them, Jah, and let them fall. Strike through the wicked all for me. Yeah. No, sorry about that, see, but we just make you know the punchline, princess. Bless. Yeah.
Tell us about how you got involved with BBG.
Well, how I got involved with BBG, I went on a TV program on TVJ. Yeah, we just big up TVJ. Big up every media still, but TVJ, I went on a program that I'm called Rollout. Program.
That's the program on Smile Jamaica.
Yes, Smile Jamaica, right. And I went there and sing a song in the morning, like I went on the 6th of June, yeah, and sing on the TV in the morning. But first, before I got a TV station, like going at the hours in the night, and just know one of my family, because everyone lock off in their own quarters and things. So, see one of my little brother and them say, no, so I'm going to look on the TV tomorrow. So, I'm kind of surprised, like, I say, yo, TV tomorrow, I lie, and I say, yeah, man, TV, German car, I get a thing shot, you know. Try something, guys. We need to get out of this, guys. To be honest, I have this sweet voice. Everyone at them say, yo, singer, you're big and you're bad and you're this and that and nothing. So me, when me hear about the TV, me just know, say, yeah, I'm going to run out the man in there. Wishing me, I'm going to say, I'm going to put on TV. So tell them that. Left out the early morning. Yeah. Go over the TV station. When me go over TV, Jay, me never did know, say, I roll out and I go for like a competition thing, because if I did really deal with competition, I would enter Rising Star or any something. Because in a competition, I know say every artist are the baddest, every artist are the best. So I mean, I enter a competition for a long time. Me want to find a producer. You know what I mean? So I say, yeah, I get the shine if I go up on the TV. Somebody must have seen it. So when I go over the station, I get to find us a roll out something where it's a competition. In terms of you sing for a minute. Deliver your thing and then who win. You know how TV goes. Somebody will call it, but it's a form of exposure. So we go over there and come through. The judges them at first. You don't know it, but two virgin sing first and then we sing last. And the last shall be the first shall be the last. Them sing first and then get all the vote. When we come on last, it's like the judges start with a win. So I get crazy. Me never did feel no way differently from that. Because I go there the Friday and the Sunday was my daughter's birthday. So I was my daughter for self better life. So if I get away, like, feel a buzz, but if I get away, then I can find myself a competition. So I just tweet, give it the best shot. Okay? After that, leave the TV station. When we went at the front desk, people them at the desk, like, you know, receptionist or whatever say, Isola, like singing and you have a number for you and give me a number. Me, I don't tell a lie, come roll on somebody call me, but me go call the person. Them just like me. Them just like me, cause I say no. So remember when you go for a roll out, cause some boss me, so I'm not gonna do it. So don't remember this. You see when you go at the front next when you left when you win and you get a number, but some people will like you. Who need you gonna call you, okay? So don't waste your credit and let them waste theirs. But them now got have your number because the producer them don't set up like that. That's why they leave their number. So when you get a number and a real no producer, I don't say fan. And them can't let your number give them because them check them out already and find out if it's not a producer. So that's why we get the number. So me call them and think it was a producer. So yeah, so you understand that. Anyway, I go home and did thing. Everybody I say, yo, Zola, nice. Wait. I sat them on and I get a phone call about 8:45 because it's true. I never forget it. And like, I say, hello. Yeah, hello, this is Isola. And I say, yeah, this is Isola. This is Conley. Yeah? This is Conley. This is Conley from War 21. So me now say, War 21, who? Because you know, you're there on a vibe, man. You're just a man. So when you hear War 21, I'm kind of frightened to you know. So me I say, 21. And Conley I say, Yeah, man, War 21, man. The producer for the program, give me your number and interest in your talent. We love your singing real bad. And right now, Wednesday, me and Mentor rhythm, and me see you Friday, and you me sip on the rhythm. So me I say, see what's for true? And I say, yeah, man. And me I say, send the rhythm, come give me now, then, that. And I say, yeah, man, me I send it right now. By 8:45, I'm talking about 8:50, the rhythm reach. And I listen by 9 o'clock. Start building the song by Saturday. But 2 o'clock in a second, the Sunday we'll build the song. My brother DYC will come over to me and him there and I will have vibes and I put it together and thing. And you see everything that happened in a twinkling of eyes. So we just say, yo, there. So that is how we get link up with War 21. Wild Tunes, it caused by Rollout and Conley. McCarthy called me the Saturday morning. So everything happened in a twinkling of eyes. Went on Friday and get called Saturday. So give thanks. That's the way how I meet War 21. Wild True. BBG family. And then so we meet and get the rhythm. So we meet. So you can ask about the song or the rhythm. Ask. You ask.
You can't tell me what to ask.
I'm sorry.
Right. So tell us now where you see yourself. Next year, next 5 years,
how do you feel about the progress that is always being? Well, right now, to how I feel real good, and still just a whole of vibes here, you know what I mean? I hope for the best, guys. Don't know life setup. You know what I mean? So it's like we start with Thunderball and it is a hit song, then Izula just stop the homework and start with this and be this and that and no. The next 5 years, BBG taking care of a lot of people, man. Yeah, man. Lot of people have food, yeah? So the next 5 years, Izula, huge. Seriously. But I'm here. So that's the end. Because now I have the thing, you know. When I say have the thing, I mean, I find a home, you know. I have the family in the recording business, in the music. That's what when I did a search, that's why I did come out. So I have a family them now to deal with it, so. The next 5 years, I want to tell you, so the next month, cleaner. The next month, cleaner. The next year, you have a company in Jamaica then, Digicel, but bigger and better. So, 5 years time, a different interview, because I like some things. Like I'm looking at baby and some around me and them. Next interview, I go, all right. Because the world will come to take care. I swear, so that's the idea. So we have a big BBG family. We're good. We just have all the humbleness. And just try deal with the message and the music and keep the natural, when I say natural, I mean spirit. Because if we don't do this, with that subterranean in spirit, some people, well, Rastafari, blessed Lord. When we say spirit, we don't talk about dopey Rasta. I go say soul then. Just like we do with reggae with soul. That's, we can win souls, okay? And that's what I'm doing. So next 5 years, next decade, the day and until ever.
Alright, so we're gonna wrap now and I want to leave us with a piece of Izula that is to be cemented.
Yeah.
Within us, the audience, we want something solid. So we know when we hear Izula, we will say that is Izula.
Yeah. When you say something cemented,
something soulful, you just talk about something.
Oh, so you want me to sing?
Yes, Rasta.
Oh! I never know. Yes, I think as.
No.
Rastafari, right. Well, give ever praises to the Almighty. And singing, I want to somewhere The Almighty bless me with me, give her thanks. Because we do it for fun. We just do it for joy. That's what I tell you. We have purpose and really find out why we have to do this. Because the world needs it. Alright? So may I leave you with that song you know, as we are saying now, that people can hear it in their head and never forget it. Jah is Mr. Knows It All. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he knows about it all. Yeah. Jah is Mr. Know It All. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he knows about it all. Whoa. He knows about your pain. He knows about your sorrow. He will tell if you will live to see another tomorrow. Jah is Mr. Know It All. Yeah, and we know that. Because he knows it. The reggae music need BBG, need Isola. Yeah, blessed love, yeah? Give thanks.
And it's a wrap.
Celestia, bless.
Oh, you get to take part. I get to take part. No, I'm not.